Service has issued a tornado warning.
At Edgerton Elementary in Greenfield, there was a pop quiz of sorts.
Please move quickly and quietly to your designated area at this time.
And they passed their test. With the fire chief looking on, the kids participated in a statewide tornado drill. As tornado sirens sounded outside, inside, students exercised the familiar duck and cover, away from windows and doors.
Boys and girls, you did a very nice job.
As smartphone apps and weather radios become more popular, some question the value of an old-fashioned siren. A few Wisconsin towns like Antigo have gotten rid of them. Back in 2012, the city of Brookfield proposed their removal, but dropped the plan after heavy public backlash. It ended up adding two more.
There's really not one single replacement that can do it all.
Greenfield's fire chief says the tornado siren is one of the key components to protect people from severe weather, along with smartphones, weather radios, and their municipal alert systems.
And when it comes to tornadoes, severe weather, redundancy is the key.
Greenfield has four sirens. They cost about $30,000 each and about $250 a year to maintain. The chief considers it an important investment in public safety.
These are devastating events as we've seen throughout the country, so we take it seriously.
The sirens across the state will sound again at 6:45 tonight as part of the drill, except here in Milwaukee County. Emergency officials were worried that with all that action downtown, the pep rally at the Bucks game, that there might be confusion in the city of Milwaukee. Everywhere else in the state, you'll hear them ring at 6:45. In Milwaukee, Colleen Henry, WISN 12 News. And there is-